I can give you an example of the risk assessment we have conducted in Iran around earthquake. When this was done, it was done basically by Tehran University Department of Public Health. They took the leadership, working closely with the Ministry of Health, and then, under the auspices of the Ministry of Health, engaging the development partners in the process, they conducted the risk assessment. The outcome of the risk assessment, the risk profile, they used in the operational planning. So in the consecutive earthquake response, we say that the resource mobilization is very smooth, their decision-making process is very smooth because it's informed decision, and the policymakers and also like all the stakeholders around the table, they know quite well. And the social mobilization became very easy because you are informing the communities something that you took the information from the communities. So you actually earned the trust there. Mm-hmm. So this worked, altogether, the whole mechanism worked very well. So the other aspect I would say that when you talk about risk assessment, one concern come up with everybody that where do you get the resources from? Because it's a very competitive world of resources. You don't get the resources just like to do anything. So engaging everybody, including the communities, engaging the partners, you are actually engaging their assets, their resources, be it technical resource, be it financial resource, and be it an information level. Because they're engaged, they are owning the whole process, and the resource is not an issue then.